Okay, so this is the structure of mitochondria. You are already familiar with the structure of mitochondria. It is having an outer membrane and inner membrane. Both membranes are phospholipid bilayers, just like any other membrane. The region between the two membranes is called as the intermembrane space. The inner membrane is folded to form finger-like projections called cristae, which increase the surface area for ATP production. What is this inner membrane having? It is having stock particles, which have the enzyme ATP synthase, which are responsible for synthesis of ATP. Inside the mitochondria, there is matrix, and the matrix is having 70S ribosomes and circular DNA. Now, if we study how ATP is synthesized, so we need to magnify and see what's happening across the inner membrane and the matrix. And the process is called as chemiosmosis. What is chemiosmosis? Now look at the diagram here. I have just magnified this portion, which is in the box here. I have magnified here. What I've done, I have added an appropriate color, and at the top with the labels here, you can see, for example, the red line here represents the outer membrane. The green part here represents the intermembrane space. The yellow line here represents the inner membrane. This light blue dots, these represent the matrix. This dark blue mushroom-like structure in the inner membrane is your stalk particle, and the pink part of the stalk particle is the ATP synthase. All you need to keep in mind is that the intermembrane space is having a high H plus concentration, and the matrix is having a low H plus concentration. This establishes an electrochemical gradient. If given a chance, H plus will definitely go from intermembrane space to the matrix, but since it is separated by a phospholipid bilayer, which is the inner membrane, H plus cannot pass through because it's a polar substance. And you know polar substance cannot cross a phospholipid bilayer. So there you have the ATP synthase in the stalk particle, which is having a channel that allows H plus ion to move from the intermembrane space to the matrix by the process of facilitated diffusion. When H plus ions are moving from the intermembrane space to the matrix, this rounded portion of ATP synthase, it synthesizes ATP. How it synthesizes ATP? Just come to this diagram here. I am representing this with a circle. This circular part is the ATP synthase. It is having two main parts. A rounded part called as the gamma portion. This is the gamma portion which rotates when H plus ions are passing through it. You can see the yellow dot in the center. This yellow dot is the same dot which you can see here on the mushroom-like structure. Don't quote the mushroom-like structure as that mushroom-like structure. I'm just giving you an analogy here so you can picture how a stalk particle in ATP synthase may look like. So from this region which I have shaded yellow, H plus ions can cross. And when they are crossing, this gamma portion starts to rotate. So ATP synthase is having a gamma portion which can rotate, and the ATP synthase enzyme is also having three binding sites. One binding site holds ADP and PI, the other binding site holds ATP, and the third binding site releases ATP. So when H plus ions are passing through this central region of the ATP synthase, gamma portion starts to rotate, and as it rotates, ATP is produced and released. This entire process is called as chemiosmosis. And the force which is generated because of the movement of H plus ions from high concentration to low concentration, moving from the intermembrane space to the matrix, this force is called as the proton motive force. Now, I hope you can recall we discussed proton motive force as a general term in our earlier slides when we were discussing substrate level phosphorylation. We learned that in substrate level phosphorylation, proton motive force is not required. We also learned in oxidative phosphorylation that proton motive force is required. When we are discussing chemiosmosis, the first and the foremost question that arises in our mind is how this intermembrane space ended up having a high H plus concentration to begin with. Why is the intermembrane space having high H plus concentration? Why the matrix is having a low H plus concentration? So this will be answered later when we are discussing oxidative phosphorylation in detail. So I hope Chemios Masters is clear.